Just briefly, Ambassador, I know you want to get on a plane, so I want to thank you for your indulgence today. Once again, the American people have seen another failure of their preposterous conspiracy theory, which that's if their conspiracy theory doesn't change between now and our next hearing, which is in a few hours from now or another hour or so, and it keeps changing every day. The claim, Ambassador, that you had an irregular, you were accused of having an irregular channel, drug deals, now supposedly you're one amigo. Nobody on this side of the aisle claimed that you were one amigo.
I lost my amigos?
Yeah, not from us, not from us. No bribes given to, that you made any bribes to the Ukrainian people or to the Ukrainian president. Your co-conspirator, Kurt Volker. I find it remarkable and troubling how the Democrats and their collaborators in the press have been able to vilify Ambassador Volker, who was supposed to work on these matters in Ukraine, like you, Ambassador. It was a very regular channel, and no amount of storytelling by the left and the Democrats on this dais will change that. It was the regular channel. Testimony received today was far from compelling, conclusive, and provides zero evidence of any of the crimes that have been alleged. In fact, Ambassador Sondland testified that he presumed the temporary pause in military aid was conditioned on Ukraine carrying out the investigations the Democrats are desperate to portray as nefarious. The Democrats have, as their custom, seized on this presumption as proof they can use it against the president. However, Ambassador Sondland testified in his deposition that when he asked President Trump, "What do you want from Ukraine?" President Trump replied, "I want nothing. There is no quid pro quo." Let me repeat. President Trump said, "I want nothing. There is no quid pro quo." This comes on the heels of the testimony by Ambassador Volker that he saw no evidence of bribery, extortion, quid pro quo, or treasonous actions. We didn't get to ask him about obstruction of justice because we didn't know that was on the table until today. Like the president's call with President Zelensky, Democrats want the American people to believe, as one Democrat on this committee put it, that hearsay is much better than direct evidence. And I think Mr. Ratcliffe from Texas laid out the direct evidence that we have from your testimony today. Nothing we have heard establishes a claim that the president acted improperly in his dealings with Ukraine, and certainly nothing has been presented to support anything near impeachment. In the meantime, Mr. Chair, we continue to have no answers to the questions that only you know, starting with who is the whistleblower who gave birth to this hoax, and what was the nature of his coordination with the Democrats on this committee? Second, what is the full extent of Ukraine's election meddling against the Trump campaign in 2016? And finally, why did Burisma hire Hunter Biden? What did he do for them? And did his position impact any U.S. government actions under the Obama administration? Another hearing in the books and no answers to basic three material factual questions that we need answers to. Yield back, and thank you, Ambassador, for being here.